everyone. Matt Devin alongside of Mike Fratello and Marty Snyder. One of the best in the game, Kevin Durant, has said he can do more. And when you look at this, coach, quite frankly, his teammates need to do more.
Kevin Durant has been simply spectacular. 32 points per game, over 12 rebounds per game, 10 free throw attempts per game, shooting 50% from the floor. But he was near exhaustion in the last game in the fourth quarter. The guy that has to step up, Kevin Martin. James Harden is gone. Martin was brought in to put up his numbers, shooting just 38%, only 3 free throw attempts per game. They need a big night from him if they're going to win.
In game 3 here, Ned Wood has been called affectionately the Grindhouse. The Memphis Grizzlies won 87-81. That is a season low performance offensively for the Thunder. Our officiating crew, Joe Crawford in his 36th season, James Capers in his 18th season, and Bennett Salvatore in his 31st season.
You're talking about a veteran crew, and this crew might tend to call it a little more closely on the physical contact. That's good for Oklahoma City.
And we are underway in the Grizzlies, home possession of the basketball, to begin game 4. Conley. Here's Marc Gasol. He has scored 20-plus in the first 3 games of this series. Conley with a jumper to start. And on the glass, Serge Ibaka.
Kind of the unsung hero for Memphis has been Zach Randolph. His numbers aren't great, but he has caused Oklahoma City to pay so much attention to him. He's put so many fouls on the big men that it's opened up things for other people. We see an offensive foul immediately on the screen.
Perkins earns his first. The bigs in this series for the Thunder have struggled immensely. Whether it be Serge Ibaka, Kendrick Perkins, and then off of the bench, Nick Collison, Marc Gasol, and Zach Randolph. And despite Randolph's 8 points in game 3, they have had their way. And as you mentioned, so much attention on Randolph, the 2-time All-Star for the Grizzlies, as he goes in strong. Gasol on the offensive glass and kicked out of bounds by Randolph. It'll be Thunder basketball.
Well, Ibaka had a tough time guarding Zach Randolph, and they had to drop 2 and 3 other people around him to help Ibaka. Ibaka's not a big wide body. He jumps quickly. He's very athletic. But he's also going to have a tough time handling Gasol, who's long and wide and big.
Durant. Conley, just named second team. All deep, digs in and steals it. Gasol also named to that second team All-D in the NBA. Tony Allen, first team. Zach Randolph, offensive rebound, put back, and it doesn't go. Still looking for the first bucket here of game 4. Cephalosha gives it to Reggie Jackson. Durant on the drive. Short corner, here's Perkins. Pocket 7. 6 on the inside, altered shot. And a foul on the floor.
You know if you are down 3-1, you're in trouble. So a must-win for Oklahoma City. Durant wearing down. Think about that fourth quarter, just 3 of 11 in the second half. And who steps up? We already said it. Kevin Martin has to step up.
Cephalosha jumper in and out. Durant, 46 minutes in game 3. Played all 24 minutes of the second half. And an offensive foul is going to be charged to Zach Randolph. You mentioned this at the top with this veteran crew.
Yeah, they're calling it tight right now. They don't want this to get out of control. On the move, you see the defender, Durant, trying to get over. Randolph moves into him. A good call by the officials. And going back to that wearing down, remember, Durant missed 2 big free throws down the stretch, 5 of 9 from the free throw line, just 3 of 11 in the second half of the last game.
Durant, the 3 is good. Scott Brooks, in talking to him, said, look, we can't rest him. So we have long timeouts. We check with him throughout the game. And sure, there are times when he says he's fine and he may not be. But he said, you try to read that. But he said, it just seems that every time we take him out of the game, the Grizzlies will go on a 7-2, 9-2 run.
And that's what happened last game. Oklahoma City was right there. They sit him down. All of a sudden, Memphis goes up 10 to 12. He has to put Durant back in the game. And he himself single-handedly got him back to a 1-point lead at halftime.
Ibaka earning his first. Here's Conley. Cephalosha on him. An adjustment made for game three. And Ibaka tears down the rebound.
Remember, they want to run. They want to push to get shots in transition.
Here's Jackson. Leans into it. And Jackson cans a jumper. They want pace.
Remember, last game, 23 points in the fast break for the Thunder. Only 7 for Memphis.
Gasol off the mark. It's interesting, Lionel Hollins, in speaking to him, he felt that leading up to game three, both teams are a little bit overhyped as Cephalosha and the Thunder are off to a sensational start as they lead 7-0, and Memphis is 0-7 from the field.
Back in Memphis with Oklahoma City up early, 7-0. You know, there's two big questions facing the Thunder coming into this game. Number one, what role players will step up in the absence of Russell Westbrook? And number two, can Kevin Durant possibly give more? I asked Scott Brooks that question earlier today. He told me, I can't imagine Kevin Durant giving us more. But when I asked Kevin Durant that question, he said, absolutely, my game can get better.
I think it's another level I can go to. You know, always can be better. That's how I look at things. And my teammates need me more than ever now. Coaches need more from me. So I got to dig deep and see where I can find it from.
And in that interview, he went on to tell me basketball is one thing, but what's really challenged me is pushing my leadership skills, being an encouraging leader. He said, I've been texting my guys every day, win or lose in this series. He said, basketball will only take us so far. Building my guys up, being a good leader, that's what will take us to the next level.
All right, Marty, Zach Randolph ends a drought for the Grizzlies. Durant, since the loss of Westbrook, has accounted for 52% of his team's points.
Well, as the series has gotten longer, he went from 35 points, 36 points, and then all of a sudden down to 25 last game, 46 minutes in that game, and a layup on the inside missed by Perkins. He has got to convert those high percentage shots.
It has been a struggle, not only for Perkins, but also Serge Ibaka. Zach Randolph on the inside. 4-0 spurt coming out of the timeout. Jackson to Durant. Ibaka comes up to set the screen. Ibaka hesitant there. And a defensive 3-second violation on the Memphis Grizzlies, and Kevin Durant will head to the free throw line. You look at the first quarter in this series, and the Thunder haven't led after the first quarter in any one of the games. Durant has accounted for 27 of the 53 points that have been combined by the Thunder in that first quarter. He is shooting 9 of 16. The rest of his teammates, 9 of 45 from the field. You got to start better. They have thus far. Turnover. Ibaka.
Another backdoor. Last time Cephalosha got the dunk. And that time, the weak side or offside defense of Memphis right there to close down the front of the rim.
Thunder with 3 turnovers. They lead by 4. Conley up top. Averaging career playoff best. Here's Prince turning the corner at the elbow, gives it up. Conley the three. Got it.
He has become such a much more confident shooter, and he has increased his range this past season.
Durant on the inside. Prince.
Would you say that's a bad shot? Of course it's a bad shot, but he thought he had gotten contact and was going to get the whistle, so he wanted it in the act of shooting.
Randolph denied. Ibaka gives it to Reggie Jackson. Jackson to Rand. And a turnover as Perkins, he felt he was going to be cutting to the hole, and he wasn't.
When you set a screen on a pick-and-roll situation, you must roll out of there quickly. Your partner knows whether you're a jump shooter or a roll guy. Big men got to get out of there quickly, get to a spot to receive the pass.
No turnovers. Early. Prince. And a 1-point advantage for Memphis. 9-1 run. Jackson. Here's Ibaka. Ibaka, his first field goal made in the first quarter of this series.
Didn't Scotty Brooks tell us that he is the best 16-foot jump shooter on the basketball team? He's just been missing shots and lost his confidence.
Gasol. Here's Reggie Jackson. Jackson gives it to Cephalosha, cut off by Conley, trailing the play. Perkins. Durant. 5 o'clock. Here's Perkins. Kick out. Ibaka. And Serge Ibaka with five straight now for the Thunder.
Probably the best thing that happened to Scotty Brooks, that he sees Ibaka make a couple jump shots here in the first quarter.
Conley comes up short prior to those last two shots. Here's Jackson, wildly out of control, and Conley scoops it up and calls a timeout. Serge Ibaka, just 30% in this series. He's been such a huge story, the void of his offense during the regular season. He averaged 13 points, 7.5 rebounds. 0-12 in the first quarter combined over the last three games. First three of this series. Here's Conley. Another three for Mike Conley. Tight early. It's been tight throughout this series. There have been 49 lead changes through the first three games combined. Heading into game four, and a whistle and a foul and a foul on Zach Randolph. That is his second.
Conley just seems to hit big three-point shots at the right moment. For the regular season, he shot 36% from the three-point line. But after the first three games in this series, Conley's shooting just 28%. But the ones he's made, all so important to his team's momentum.
And Ibaka heading to the line, and Ibaka 75% during the regular season, 4 of 6 in this series. Thunder and Grizzlies fans get their news first with the TeamStream app. Download TeamStream from the App Store or Google Play and stay in the know. Get TeamStream from Bleacher Report.
Also checking in for the Grizzlies, number 55, Keon
Dooling in for Conley. Kevin Martin checking in for the Thunder. Darrell Arthur on the floor and replaces Zach Randolph. And a great start for Serge Ibaka. He had a double-double in game three, 13 points and 10 rebounds. However, he was 6 of 17 from the field.
Well, the difference in the beginning right here, Memphis got off to such a terrible start, 0 for 7 shooting, and then come back and make 5 out of 8. But it's the 5 turnovers for Oklahoma City that have stopped their offense.
Leading to 8 points. Gasol with a layup around Ibaka.
And you could see, even with his great jumping ability, when you let Gasol get that close to the basket, Ibaka had no chance.
Gasol, his first field goal. Jackson. Durant passed through. Durant with Prince on him. Skip pass. Martin on the drive. Martin, bucket, and the foul. And Scott Brooks telling us one of the issues when you go back to game three with Kevin Martin, he didn't get to the free throw line.
He's only averaging 3 free throw attempts per game. This is not a driver slasher. He's more of a spot up, pull up jump shooter in transition. That time he made the effort to show it, put it on the floor, got fouled, finished it off, 3-point play.
Thunder by 4. 3:30 remaining in the opening quarter of game 4 here from the FedEx Forum. In the Mid-South, Memphis, Tennessee. Gasol, 1 of 5. Here's Cephalosha. Gives it to Jackson. Jackson exploding to the rim. Two-handed slam. by Reggie Jackson.
And he knew he had this all caught in that nowhere's man. Not up high enough to take the charge. Couldn't get to him to block it, so he attacked the rim and finished like he should.
6-point lead. Tony Allen spinning. Lays it softly off of the window. Jackson has had to step in the absence of Russell Westbrook after being injured in the first round against Houston in game two. Serge Ibaka, so much conversation about it's in his mind, as Kevin Durant said, and lack of confidence. But yet here he is, 3 of 4, 9 points. Gasol under 10 of the shot clock, spinning. Nice move along the end line.
Remember what Durant said to Marty in that interview, the sit-down they had. He said, I've got to get my teammates involved to give them confidence. And that's what he did by throwing that last pass to Ibaka. He knows he's got it going now. Once again, he gives the ball back to Ibaka. He wants to keep that power forward.
Durant just so special. Clock down to 2. Durant gives it up. Here's Jackson, the 3. Got it. Another case of what you're just talking about. Makes the basketball play. Jackson 3 of 3, 7 points. Tony Allen to the rim, comes up short, and Ibaka with a rebound. Durant steps into that 3.
There's that pace that Oklahoma City feels they have to play with. Remember, when they had Russell Westbrook, he created that pace. Well, he's not here now.
Game 1, 14 points for the Thunder in the first quarter. Game 2, 21. Game 3, 18. Here in Game 4, in a game they desperately need, 28 points thus far. Durant gives it up. Ibaka knocked away. 102 remaining here in the first quarter.
Not to change anything. He missed, you know, some easy shots that he normally makes, and we feel confident that he's going to make those shots this time around. So, you know, I just told him not to put too much pressure on yourself. You know, don't let the media or your friends or your family tell you, you know, that you're struggling, that you need to pick it up, because you're going to start to think that way. You know, just always be confident in yourself. And he's a confident player, and, you know, we feel that he's going to come out and have a better game this game.
Well, he has. You look at Serge Ibaka. 9 points. And up until game 4, he had not made a field goal in the first quarter. And Ibaka 3 of 5. Durant saves that. Driving by Pondexter. Kick out. Cephalosha. Nick Collison can't control it. Gasol does. Conley back on the floor with Jared Bayless. Conley has it knocked away by Derek Fisher. Durant, Cephalosha is fouled by Bayless, and he'll head to the free throw line.
You see Oklahoma City dominating the defensive boards and out in transition. Now think about the big first quarter. Game 1, 14 points in the first quarter. Game 2, 21. Game 3, just 18, and then explode here for 28 points in the first quarter. Scotty Brooks has to feel a little bit good about the way they're playing offensively.
4-4 from the free throw line, and Cephalosha at the free throw line, and the first is good. Cephalosha in his 7th season, spent his first 2 seasons in Chicago. And you see the beat will check in.
Matt, while Oklahoma City has made all 5 of the free throw attempts that they have taken, Memphis has yet to shoot a free throw attempt. Struggling from the floor, 38%. No free throw attempts. Only 6 rebounds in the game thus far for Memphis.
And that was a major issue in game 3. The Thunder just 12 of 19 from the free throw line. The NBA's best free throw shooting team, and nearly 83% shot, 63%, and the Grizzlies 82%, attempting 28 free throws. Bayless in the corner. Pondexter. You can see Pondexter to the rim. Gasol tries to swat it away, and Fisher tracks it down.
This Gasol basically just threw the beat out of the way. He got his hand on that ball. You got to wake up quick here, put your body on, get a strong base, because he is going to test you on every rebound.
Martin up top. 7 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Game four. Martin driving. Finds Cephalosha. And the buzzer sounds, and the Thunder end the quarter on a 14-4 run over the last 3:40.
Scott, you told me this afternoon the key to this game was getting your shots to fall. How relieved are you, I guess, 56% there in the first quarter?
Making shots. It's good to see that. This is the thing that we've been doing all year. I believe in the guys. The guys believe in each other. It's good that they finally got rewarded.
You told me you had a good feeling about tonight's game. Is it the pace, though, what you wanted?
Great pace, but it's only 12 minutes. We've got 36 minutes to play. Hopefully, we continue to play with confidence.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Marty.
Pat.
All right, Marty. There's Collison. He's a backup and through, and the Thunder 11 of 20 to start this game, while the Grizzlies are 8 of 22.
You see Memphis extend their defense. Bayless is in the game. They go up court with their guards, trying to put pressure, force turnovers, take time off the shot clock.
Clock at 6, and an air ball by Randolph, and Darrell Arthur is fouled by Thabeet.
Thabeet has to realize and understand this is the playoffs now. You cannot get careless. You have to concentrate. When you secure that rebound, lock those elbows, squeeze that ball, keep it up high. Don't bring it down low where they can come in and steal it from you.
Didn't play in game three as Arthur heads to the free throw line. And one of the things that Scott Brooks pointed out when we spoke to him prior to the game is he said, despite the fact that we aren't making shots, and this is leading into game four, he said, we're not stopping the play deep. We're getting after it defensively, despite the lack of offense.
He's very proud of that thought because, as you know, most teams in the league, when they struggle offensively, it breaks their concentration. Defensively, they're going to call an offensive foul now, probably on Cephalosha for setting that moving screen.
Cephalosha, his first. 11-point advantage for the Thunder. Memphis, their only lead was 9-8. Conley trying to use a Randolph screen. Randolph rolls. Here's Arthur, a three. Doesn't go on the weak side. Batted around, and last touch by Randolph, and it's going to be Thunder basketball.
And if you get a chance to watch the matchup of Collison on Randolph, he's really done an excellent job. Now, Randolph has put a lot of fouls on him, fouled him out of the one game. But Collison is tough-minded. He uses his body, uses his position well in guarding and frustrating Randolph.
Martin the three, short, and Arthur with a rebound. Collison had five fouls in game three, fouled out of game two. Bayless pulls up, looking to shoot. Right now, this Grizzlies team void offensively. However, you know, their style of play, they get it going here on the defensive end. They can get right back in it as they trail by 11. Fisher. Great ball movement. And there's Collison crashing the glass as he comes in and gets the offensive rebound and the putback.
Well, Memphis's defense can create offense for them. They get after it. They force a couple turnovers. Remember, they had 2 24-second violations against Oklahoma City with 10:50 to go in the second quarter last game.
Conley, it pops out. Memphis shooting just 30%. The pace of play in favor of the Thunder. Here's Martin. Isolated against Bayless. And then it pops out, and Bayless commits the foul. 13-point advantage for Oklahoma City, and Bayless just picked up his second.
And you know that Martin understands he has got to be more assertive. He's got 5 field goal attempts up there already in this game. We're at the beginning of the second quarter. He's got to be aggressive going after it. He averaged about 14 field goal attempts during the season.
And you see where the series is. And in game five Wednesday in Oklahoma City, 9:30 Eastern on TNT. Grizzlies lead the series 2-1. Conley, Gasol, and Gasol and Thabeet, and Thabeet's going to pick up the foul along with Allen to Randolph. On the floor in Pondexter, Thabeet, Collison, Jackson, Fisher, and Martin on the floor for the Thunder. Thunder on a 13-2 run. The Grizzlies without a field goal the last 4:40. Here's Randolph going to work on Collison. Denied. Allen scoops it up and puts it right back up and through. And Randolph looking over at the veteran Bennett Salvatore. And veteran official saying no. Let's go ahead, get up. And a delay of game warning.
Well, as he goes up, Collison actually gets the first one. And then Thabeet gets it blocked again after Collison had blocked it, but crashes into Randolph, and that's where Randolph felt he was going to hear a whistle.
Collison underneath. Collison has come alive here in game four.
Martin had it teed up, ready to go, and then dropped it into the post area at the last second.
Foul on Fisher.
Just gotta keep playing. Listen, they hit us with a right cross. What are you gonna do? Lay on the mat and get counted out to 10, or are you gonna get back up and fight? And the only way you get back up and fight is start defending, rebounding, and being aggressive on offense.
Well, Lionel explaining that their defense has what has kept them in so many games this year. It's the staple of this team. So let's go back to what we do well. Defend, shut them down, and then our offense will come.
Conley, another first half three.
And there it is right there. They come out of the timeout, they execute, and they go to Mike Conley, who down the stretch of games in the last 4 minutes, he's probably one of the most key pieces that Memphis has out there.
Jackson dragging that pivot foot. And a turnover.
There's the defense. Coach just talked about it. They do something offensively, then come right back and do it defensively. Put pressure on the ball, gets away from him a little bit. That time, Jackson losing control, picks up that foot and drags it.
Mike Conley, 3-of-3 from three-point range. Conley swings it over to Pondexter. 5 o'clock, and as Pondexter's shot doesn't go up on the glass. Last touch by the Thunder, Memphis basketball. And a 12-point advantage for the Thunder.
Kevin Durant got a little bit of a break, but Scottie Brooks has the feeling that he needs a guy he can throw the ball to and he can create and make his own shot. So you get one of the best in the league at doing it. Kevin Durant back in the game.
Durant averaging 32.3 points in the playoffs as Tony Allen spices to the hole. 10-point game, and Scott Brooks, timeout.
Matt, as you know, there's a great passion for basketball in this city, whether it's the University of Memphis or it's the Memphis Grizzlies. These fans love their team.
Great history in high school basketball here in the city of Memphis. Penny Hardaway, one of many that have come through Memphis, Tennessee, from here. Had a great impact on the game here in the Mid-South. Pondexter to Gasol, and went to high school here at Lausanne Academy. Pondexter, shot doesn't go. Collison has been huge here in the first half. First three games, he combined to score 4 points, and Collison with 6 points and 3 rebounds.
And every time Memphis sees Durant playing Gasol, they go right down into the low post to Gasol to make Durant have to work at the defensive end.
Collison also with 2 blocks. To the cutting Martin. Oh, what a sweet dish by Durant as Martin finishes.
Rather than spotting up opposite in that deep corner, they understood that they were looking for that back cut. As soon as the defender turned his head, Martin went to the basket. Durant read it perfectly.
Lionel Hollins telling us that his bench was so key in game three. Right now, the Thunder bench 13, the Grizzlies bench 2. Durant with a Martin, Jackson, Collison, Fisher spotted up in the corner. Allen guarding Durant up top. Durant trying to use that Collison screen, and the clock is down to five. Jackson, the three, no. Gasol with a rebound. Quickly now to Conley. 6 minutes remaining in the first half. Randolph to Gasol. Gasol, no call. Randolph lays it back up and through.
When Zach Randolph wants the basketball, better get out of his way. He knocked down his own teammate and Durant at the same time going after that offensive board.
6 points, four rebounds for Randolph. Martin to Collison. Gasol on him. A great cut by Martin, and Collison finds him.
This team gives Memphis the most problems when OKC goes small, puts Durant at the four spot. The problem is he's got to guard either Gasol or Randolph. Both of them physically go after him.
Foul on the floor. 5-18. You talked about the importance of Kevin Martin. Collison finding him here.
Move without the basketball. Wind up getting high percentage shots, and big men that can pass like Collison, a beautiful thing to watch.
Collison out. Productive minutes for Nick Collison. 10th year veteran out of Kansas. Iowa Falls, Iowa. Collison, 6 points, three rebounds. Conley finally misses a three, and Ibaka comes down with a rebound. Ibaka, 9 points, eight rebounds. Jackson drives, gives it back to Ibaka, and Ibaka, even though he's set, he's feeling it. He's got that touch.
Reggie Jackson, very close to committing an offensive foul that time. Got up in the air, passed while he was up in the air. The official did not blow the whistle as Memphis tried to take the offensive foul.
See, it's a game three when he was out of control. He got called for that charge. Martin looking to give it up. Jackson gets it back. Here's Durant, quick trigger three. So smooth. Kevin Durant in the Thunder up 46-29.
Let's watch Reggie Jackson, the youngster, out in front with the basketball, and he's going to talk to his big man right here about getting out, what he wants to run offensively. Brings it over, tells Collison, move over, go to the other side of the floor. I want to get the ball here to Kevin Durant. Durant has it, looks over the floor. Here's the spot-up shooter, Kevin Martin away. Durant with the basketball is going to put it down on the floor. He sees the overloaded defense. As soon as he puts it down, the defense turns their head. That's when Kevin Martin heads to the wide-open rim. Put it down, bring the next defender, back cut, wide-open layup on the inside. Nice job between Kevin Durant, Kevin Martin, their communication and execution.
Kevin Martin, 3 of 6. Game three, 6 of 17. The Thunder team coming off of a season low 81 points. They've been held under 93 or less in the first three games. First time all year long that they have been held. As Conley makes it and is fouled at the Thunder. They have been held under 100 points in three consecutive games. And Scott Brooks talking about pace of play, playing defense. Well, they're doing that here in game four.
Actually, Reggie Jackson doesn't do a bad job. You saw him moving into him, so it's a good call by the official, but he got his body in front of him just a little bit too late. The contact came before as he was sliding under Conley.
Conley, 83% on the season from the free throw line. And after the All-Star break, averaging close to 17 points, 6.5 assists. Randolph looks to save it, and a foul. Joey Crawford, veteran official, looks at the veteran Derek Fisher and calls the foul.
And the veteran Derek Fisher knew not to challenge the veteran Joe Crawford. He just put his arms behind his back and went, okay, I give up.
Thank you. 13-point lead. Martin. And an air ball, and Scott Brooks can't believe an on-call as Bayless, and appeared as though made contact with Martin.
Martin jumped up and looked at the official. Scotty Brooks came down the sideline talking to the official, but no call was made.
Conley finds Randolph. High-low, Gasol, and a foul is going to be charged to Durant.
They went to the high-low set. Durant was fronting his big man behind him down low. They threw right back to the top, and there's Zach Randolph. And as Durant tries to come around on the baseline side, the official calls him for coming over the back of Gasol.
Gasol heads to the free throw line. 13-point advantage for Oklahoma City here in game four. Watch every press conference live. Tune in to NBA TV and NBA.com for the post-game press conferences.
So what's happened now, because of the steady pounding inside by Memphis, it forces Scott Brooks to make an adjustment. He comes back in with Perkins. That means Ibaka goes back to the power forward spot. Kevin Durant goes back to the small forward position, and now he'll be able to match up with Prince.
A Memphis team that since February 8th has won 18 of 19 at home. They lone lost back in April to the Clippers. Bucket there. KD, 12 points, so efficient, 4-6 from the field, 4 assists. Prince, Perkins, showed, and here's Gasol, has it taken away by Perkins, lead pass Durant, Durant to the cutting Martin.
And the guy that just came in the game, Perkins, makes a huge defensive play, he anticipates well, steps up, comes up with the ball, and then kicks it out to start the break.
About the lack of presence by the bigs for the Thunder in the first three games. They have shown up here in the first half. Gasol, count it, and one.
Wow, he got that up over the top of Ibaka with Durant flying at him from the top, and he was falling back as he shot it, but watch the concentration at the end. Puts it down, takes on Ibaka. Here comes Durant. Fading, look at his eyes, never leave the target as he shoots it and makes it.
Gasol, the defensive player of the year, yet named to the second team All-NBA D. It's the fourth time that that has happened, that a player has won, including last year with Tyson Chandler, won the defensive player of the year and was not named
first team. So you're the best defensive player in the league, but you're number three on the list of centers that were named to the All-League defensive teams.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And there's a reason for that, because it's the head coaches that vote for the All-Defensive team. It's the writers that vote for the defensive player of the year.
Conley, so the Randolph lays it up and through. So the coaches and the media not on the same page. A little bit different.
Yeah, it happens quite a bit.
Jackson and Conley getting tangled up there. 10-point game. Grizzlies on a run, and the 17-point first half lead has been cut to 10. And Serge Ibaka with 11 points and 8 rebounds. Kevin Martin off of the bench with 11 points. And Martin just 8 of 28 after that fantastic game one 25-point performance when he was 8 of 14 entering game four, and a total of 19 points in game two and game three. Durant out of the timeout. So sweet.
Well, if you were a coach and you call the timeout, would you know who to give the ball to if your team needed a bucket?
Even I would in that situation. 12-point lead. Conley, Prince, entry pass, Randolph. Deep post position for Zach Randolph, and turns right into the right shoulder.
basically he's under the rim. And when you let him get that deep, and look, he's wide, he's strong, he's tough. Ibaka's not that big, but you can let him get that close to the basket.
Short corner jumper, and Serge Ibaka rattles it in. 5 of 7 with 13 points for Ibaka.
And you can see the two that are matched up against each other. One does it from 2 feet away, the other does it from 10 feet out.
Already tying his series high. Ibaka, there's Bayless to three.
Bayless has come off the bench, and he seems to have a knack for making early shots when he comes out on the floor.
9-point lead for the Thunder on a minute remaining in the first half of game four. Grizzlies lead the series 2-1. Durant with an up fake. Fading over Prince. Ibaka on the glass. And a foul on the floor. The third on Randolph. Zach Randolph has responded tonight here in the first half. 10 points, 6 rebounds, and a frustrated look as he heads off of the floor, picking up his third. And
Lionel Hollins sat down with Randolph and praised him, okay, for what's been going on, and the fact that he said, don't look at your numbers and try and compare them to what you did during the regular season. You're responsible for us being in all these games, winning, having the 2-1 edge right now, because they're paying so much attention to you that it's opening up your teammates, and all we care about is we come out of the game with a win. Don't get frustrated.
That is something that Conley commits a foul. Lionel Hollins has instilled in each one of his players sacrificing for the greater good of the team, no matter what, win the game, as we send it over to Marty.
Well, Matt, what Coach was just talking about, I asked Zach Randolph about that yesterday. He told me, listen, people are saying I'm having a bad series. Those people are wrong. I'm doing all kinds of things to help us win games. Three guys are crashing on me at one time, clearly having more success tonight. But he said, 5 years ago, this series would have frustrated me. I would have been angry, I would have been upset, and I would have mentally checked out of the series. This year, I'm just happy to win and move on. And that calling out in the film session, Coach Fratello, that Lionel Hollins did meant everything to Zach Randolph. He said, listen, you're doing a great job. You're the reason we're winning these games.
And the other point is that Lionel Hollins said, look, this guy has really matured. Came to Memphis, didn't have the greatest of reputation as far as being a teammate, being a selfish player, caring more about stats than winning. And he said, this guy has done a complete turnaround. You can't say any of those things about him now. He just comes to work. He's a leader. The players on the team love him. He's one of the reasons, big reasons, why we are where we are right now.
Well, Hollins said when they acquired him, he defined who they are as a team. 8 on the shot clock. Gasol double comes. Conley to Bayless over Jackson. The three is good. Jared Bayless once again. Eight-point game. 8 seconds remaining in the first half. Durant with Prince on him. Durant, deep three. No. Ibaka right there. Joey Crawford saying, count the bucket, and they will look at it. And Joey Crawford telling Kevin Durant and the Thunder, go ahead and go, as James Capers and Bennett Salvatore all come together. And they will walk over and review it.
And you'll see, watch if the red light comes on before it's out of the hands of the offensive rebounder. That looks close right there. Very, very close.
See.
That's not going to count. Ball still touching his hand. That is not going to count.
Joe Crawford right now. In communication with our truck and producer Glenn Diamond. And Ibaka. And we're going to say that it was no good. Still in his hand. If 56 points, the most in a half this series for the Thunder, shooting 54%, yet the Grizzlies responding late in that second quarter.
Same thing that happened last game, except it was Oklahoma City who came back just before the half.
Let's send it over to Marty Snyder. Marty?
Well, spent some time with Lionel Hollins as he came out. He said they simply played harder than us and punched us in the mouth in the beginning of the game. And despite shooting only 41%, he focused on the defensive end. He said we have to guard our guys, play our game. He said we haven't played like this all year long. We're completely out of character. And it was a short halftime for the guys. They were out a good 3 minutes before Oklahoma City. He said, simple, guys, we have to play harder and smarter in this half. Matt?
Cephalosha with a block down and an air ball, and Cephalosha and Tony Allen colliding, and you see Tony Allen down on his knees and now getting back up.
Cephalosha looked back at the official and said, didn't you see contact right there? Isn't that a foul? And you see Allen doubled over there. He was still kneeling down on the ground. That's a tough one to miss.
Prince driving right in the lane, and it's a six-point game.
Prince trying to put a little pressure on Durant by attacking him off the dribble, making him work at the defensive end.
4 points, one assist for Tayshaun Prince. Durant up top, Prince on him. Under 10 of the shot clock. Durant. Cephalosha, touch pass underneath. Ibaka in a crowd. Gasol with a block, takes it away. Here's Conley. And the defense stepping up here for the Grizzlies, as you would expect, and a foul. And it is on Kendrick Perkins, and that is his second.
Well, think about what happened just then. Ibaka in the first half got himself going by being 14, 16 feet away, facing up, making jump shots. That time, he got himself down in the low post area, and the Memphis defense was smothering.
Gasol. Four-point game. On their feet. At the Grindhouse. He can quiet any crowd.
Well, he sat them back down quickly. Up on their feet, chanting defense. He just casually takes it, shoots it, hits the bottom of the net. They all sit back down.
17 points, 4 of 5 from three-point range. Durant. Allen. Cephalosha comes away with it. Here's Durant across the timeline. Durant finds Perkins. Perkins out to Jackson along the three-point line. 7-point game. Clock at 5. Jackson stumbling, loses it. Conley scoops it up. Randolph ahead. Allen, Prince. No call. Ibaka with it. Durant once again.
That was quite an exchange right there. You've got physical play taking place at both ends of the floor. That was big defensive stops right there. And then Oklahoma City cashing it in transition, finding Durant in the corner.
It was 4, back to 10 now. Prince driving. And out of bounds along the end line. And it's going to be Thunder basketball.
When they get their fast break opportunities, you know Oklahoma City wants to run and run hard. And the guy who gives it up on the break winds up being the guy who's in the deep corner opposite as they reverse it. He does not hesitate in knocking down another jump shot.
36 consecutive playoff games of scoring 20 or more. Durant, 7 of 12, 20 points. Perkins up top, Gasol on him. Cephalosha. Ibaka asking for it. Randolph guarding him. Clock down to 3. Ibaka. Perkins up fake on the inside, and Perkins. As the shot clock buzzer sounds.
Perkins finally with a field goal. Now 1 of 4 from the floor.
8-0 Thunder run is ended by Conley and with a layup. Ten-point game. Ibaka with a miss.
That's the shot that he was getting in the first half and making it.
Prince. Here's Randolph on the inside, and Randolph is fouled.
Perkins coming over to rotate and try to get Randolph in that double team, commits his third foul, and he's looking at the officials saying, hey, I was straight up with my arms. Yeah, but the body was on the move. That's where the foul was called on the collision.
His third, Randolph at the free throw line. Randolph, his first free throw attempt in a game four, and it's good. Nine-point game, 7-41 remaining in the third. Bayless was a major factor in that second quarter when Lionel Hollins' team made a push. Let's take a look at the Western Conference bracket. Grizzlies lead here, 2-1. And how about San Antonio and Golden State? What a series is. Game five, Tuesday, 9:30 Eastern on TNT.
Those young guys really pushing the veterans. So Crawford called a foul that time on Conley on the perimeter. But just when you think that San Antonio might put them away, they keep coming back at you. Got great shot makers. That crowd at home has been sensational for Golden State.
Conley, his third. 7:30 remaining here in the third. And Perkins. And Conley. And grabs a rebound. He had 10 rebounds in game two in the victory in Chesapeake Energy Arena. Gasol turns and looks for Randolph. Randolph quickly out to Conley. Quick move right to the rim. And it rolls out. Durant on the break. Durant driving. Offensive foul. That's his second.
Kevin Durant going so hard, and Memphis just gambles. Bayless steps in front, figures that momentum he'll never be able to stop. Martin's teeing it up, or Cephalosha rather, teeing it up, getting ready to shoot it. Instead, they call Durant for running over the top of him.
Conley, the three. Five-point game, timeout, Thunder. Durant, 20 points, 7-12 shooting, 6 assists. And his team up by 5, they led by as many as 17.
So important of these coaches to take timeouts at the right time to try to stop the momentum of their opponents. You just can't let a team get on a big run in the playoffs. The team puts together 4 or 5 points. Time to stop them right there with a timeout if you have to use it.
7-0 Grizzlies run following the Thunder's 8 straight points. 6:35 remaining in the third. Durant up top. Durant puts it on the floor. 6 on the clock. Durant fading. 22.
What a tough shot. As he put that ball on the floor from the right-hand corner, he saw his teammate back cut. He picked up the dribble, was about to pass, realized his teammate wasn't open, and then had to continue and shoot it in that motion and makes the shot.
Since Westbrook's injury, averaging 34. Clock to 5 for Memphis. Prince. Bayless triggers a 3. Off the mark, and Ibaka in the crowd comes away with a rebound.
Ibaka really going after the ball. We see Jackson right there take it down the floor. Sidestep Connolly. Connolly thought he was going right. He stepped, came back, finished it on the inside.
And Scott Brooks telling us that despite the turnovers by Reggie Jackson in late game situations. He cannot complain about the way he has played last season. Did not play in the postseason. Of course, he is thrust right in to the action when Westbrook went down in game two against Houston.
Look, he's very pleased with the way that he's played. You can't expect the youngster get thrown into a situation where you're taking over for an all-star point guard, a guy who's such a key, vital piece to how this team plays and has been successful, a guy who played all 82 games during the regular season. All of a sudden, you know what? You're out there as the starter for that team.
Perkins will sit with four fouls. Nick Collison, productive in that second quarter, checks in. There's Gasol. He's got 13 now. Gasol 5-10, 7-point game. Ibaka has found that range in the touch. 6 of 11 to 15 points and 12 rebounds.
We're back to the beginning of the game. Remember, that was the shot that he got to start out. Dead on, top of the circle area, one step inside it maybe. He made it then. That's almost like a replay. Same shot.
Series best performance with 15 points. Conley driving and a foul. In this 9-point game, game four, as the Thunder look to even the series. And Conley will head to the free throw line. And you see the struggles of the first three, but not the case tonight.
Playing with way more confidence tonight. Once you get off and hit, you know, two out of your first three or two for two in the game, it gives that player the understanding that, all right, tonight's my night. I'm back in my groove. I am a good shooter. And there it is. I feel it now.
Let's go to Marty.
Well, guys, we've talked about that jumper for Ibaka, the 15 to 17 footer, and Coach Brooks says he's as good as Kevin Durant at that shot. He really worked on that shot this summer, and the guy standing right beside him in the lane is the one who helped him, Mark Gasol. They were on the Spanish national team together. They would show up every day early for practice, and they developed that jumper, 15 to 17 footer, worked on it every day. Maybe Gasol taught him too much, guys, and wish he could take some of that back now.
Collison has it knocked away. And Joe Crawford calling a foul.
You see the drive on the inside, the dip off, and on the dump off, the crowd feels that it's a clean block from behind the official calling the follow through, pulling the arm down. That's why he's putting him on the line for two.
First good for Collison. Allen picking up the foul, his second. And Collison, as you mentioned before, through the first three games, a combined 4 points. And through the first three games of this series, Mark Gasol has combined to score 64 points. The three bigs, Ibaka, Collison, Perkins, combined 41 points. Getting productivity tonight. Another Thunder out of their three bigs. Here's Bayless. Back over to Conley. Conley, 20-point effort. Conley dumps it off Allen. Gasol right there.
Randolph, Gasol, as soon as that man leaves to rotate or go block the shot, they go right to the front of the rim. If that ball falls off, they're there to clean it up.
Jackson, Ibaka with an up fake. Arthur picks him up. Number 10 of the shot clock down to 7. That's 6, 5, and Collison rims out. Conley over to Arthur. There's Allen cut off by Durant. Gasol 3 of 3 in the quarter, missing his first. And last touch by the Thunder, it'll be Memphis basketball.
Tony Allen is so active. He loves this game. He's a student of the game. Lionel Hollins telling us today he was challenging the younger players by calling out plays that Oklahoma City runs and asking the younger guys, okay, what are we supposed to do on this play? How about this play? He loves doing that to the young guys.
First team, all D. Loves watching film. Knows all the play calls. Here's Bayless. Bayless, right to the rim, finishes, and is fouled. What a spark off of the bench. 8 points for Bayless.
And he finds a way of getting through the three blue jerseys, protecting the basketball, keeps his concentration. Zebo likes it from the bench.
Jackson earns his second, and Bayless heads to the free throw line. Bayless, 9 points, 12 minutes of action. Fisher gives it to Collison. 4-point game. Durant comes up empty. Conley now. Gasol. Bayless goes for the steal. Loose ball on the floor. And a timeout taken by the Thunder. And the first on Arthur. And Scott Brooks, as we mentioned back in that first half, we were talking about his defense. He said even when we weren't making shots, our defense has been there. We just got to make shots. Martin doesn't make one there. Tracked down by Arthur and nearly swatted away and taken by Martin. Bayless out of the wing. And a foul.
There's a difference being in the bonus situation. You commit a foul like that, your opponent's going to the line to shoot two free throws. Memphis still has a foul to give in this quarter.
Collison, his second. Gasol.
Changing the free throw shooter. Oh, no, I'm sorry, the official motioning to Bayless get on the line to fill the open spot. I thought he was signaling for him to get to the free throw line.
Memphis 12 of 13 from the free throw line, now 13 of 14. OKC 11 of 12. Follow all the playoff action in real time with Bleacher Report's TeamStream app. Get scores, alerts, and much more. Check out TeamStream on your phone's app store today.
See if Memphis extends their pressure defense into the backcourt now. Right now, backing up, meeting them at the half-court line rather than extending it like they did in that second quarter.
Tied at 72. Gasol with 19-10 in the quarter. Collison. Foul. He's going to be charged to Marc Gasol, his first.
Good job by Collison trying to create something. He knows the back door wasn't there. Gasol comes across the arms. Kind of an easy call for the officials. I don't know how the crowd could be upset with that one.
This is a Thunder team that is dealing with the most experienced Memphis Grizzlies playoff roster in team history. They have a combined 345 playoff games played. It's one of the reasons why when you talk to Lionel Hollins about the situation that they were in a couple of years ago. You may recall in game 4, the triple overtime thriller by the Thunder. He said, look, we're more mature. We're more poised today. And they were down 17. They tied it moments ago. It's a two-point deficit now for Memphis. The previous team best was 249 back 2005-2006. Gasol. Jump shot, no. On the glass, tracked down by Martin. Martin loses it. Allen got it. Ties it at 74.
And I'm sure that Scott Brooks right now is thinking that that was a foul. It should have been called. They'd be going to the line shooting two. Instead, it winds up an easy two for Memphis.
Tied at 74. Jackson. Conley right there with him. Under a minute remaining in the third. Jackson spinning in the lane. Kick out. Here's Fisher. Air ball. Once again. Leak out Arthur. Fisher gets back, knocks it away. It'll be Memphis basketball.
Got to remember to cover the backcourt because they're running out. You'll watch the ball inbounds. That left knee right there is what knocked Kevin Martin down, and it winds up being an easy layup on the inside. Very fortunate no call for Memphis.
Memphis by two. There is a loose ball foul.
Tony Allen committed, I believe it was Tony Allen committed the loose ball foul.
The bucket counts.
Watch Tony Allen along the baseline just shoves Kevin Martin out, and that's where the official sees it. It's an excellent call, so now he'll go to this end of the floor and shoot two.
So Tony Allen is third. Martin to the free throw line. 4 of 4 tonight. 13-3 run. And a chance here to tie the game for the Thunder. As the Grizzlies have just been tremendous here, clawing back from a 17-point deficit.
Now let's remember that Oklahoma City number one in the league this year in free throw shooting, over 82%. Right now, 15 of 16 from the free throw line in this game.
63% in game three. Bayless. His shot doesn't fall. Here's Martin, gives it to Durant. Tied at 76. Pondexter on Durant. 8 seconds remaining in the third. Durant, crossover. Durant kicks it. Here's Fisher. It is
hit that
out
clock.
Of bounds.
Hit the clock up on
with
top.
1.3. Seconds remaining in the third. Memphis basketball. Arthur to inbound it. Conley comes to it. Conley flips it up. Tied at 76. Three quarters of action. A pivotal game four.
Well, Lonnie, you told me at halftime that Oklahoma City was simply playing harder than you guys. In what ways was your effort better in the third quarter?
Every way. It was no one thing. We ran harder. We defended better. We got on the boards better.
A critical 12 minutes in this series coming up. If you guys do win, what do you need to do?
We got to go out and continue to play the same way for 12 minutes.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Matt.
Tied at 76. Fourth quarter underway. And the Thunder haven't scored a field goal in over 5 minutes. Memphis ended the third quarter on a 13-4 run. Bayless to Arthur. Jumper. Short, and Jackson comes away with a rebound.
You see now Oklahoma City backing off of the push of the basketball. Jackson that time got that rebound, slowed down, got him up into the half-court offense. First play the coach drew up.
Durant finds Martin. The three is good. Kevin Martin, 16 points. 79-76. Thunder by three. Conley pulls it back out. Finds Bayless. Bayless, too strong, and Jackson tears it down and quickly ahead. Collison up fake, comes up short trying to go over Gasol.
Just short armed at that time, never got it up high enough to give it a chance.
Thunder led back in the second quarter, 46-29. Here's Conley. Conley tonight, 4-6 from three-point range, now 4-7, 20 points, and 6-16 shooting. Martin spinning over Bayless, and he has come up big here tonight in game four.
That was a very difficult shot because Bayless put both forearms into him, hit him as he spun away from him, really knocked him off the spot, made him fade about 2 feet, and he still made the shot.
Foul. With 9:58 remaining in the fourth. Tony Allen in, Zach Randolph in as Collison picks up his third.
Let's remember, in the first three games, what Lionel Hollins has tried to do is put a number of different players on Durant early in the game. When it comes down to the fourth quarter, he wants Tony Allen guarding Durant, who thinks he does the best job.
Arthur. Darrell Arthur, 6 points. Jackson up high. Finds Durant. Durant's shot off the mark. Bayless out of transition. Allen looking for Randolph. Zach Randolph was right underneath the bucket.
And he had Collison on his back and was able to still score it. He had Collison backed under the rim so he couldn't even jump to try and block it, or he hit his head on the rim.
Foul on Bayless. Jared Bayless earning his third. With 9:20 remaining here in game four. 1 point game, Thunder by one, looking for Durant. Collison's pass picked off by Tony Allen. Allen underneath to Randolph. Collison scrapping, gets it back.
There's the battle between the two big men.
Durant along the end line. It was batted away, and Bennett Salvatore is saying that it is Thunder basketball.
We got to get every loose ball. We got to get every rebound. We got to close out every time with a good stance. We got to make sure we contest. We got to make sure we block out. And run, guys, run. We got now. Now's the time to play faster. Now's the time to play more aggressive. Now's the time to be more confident. Now's the time to find out who we are right here.
They will find out over the last 8:57 here of game four.
Scotty Brooks sound a little bit like the Reverend Mark Jackson in the Golden State timeouts.
Jackson's done a sensational job with the Golden State as Jackson's shot doesn't register. Keon dueling with Randolph, Allen, Arthur, and Bayless on the floor for Lionel Hollins. Randolph, quick, strong move.
Put his head in the chest of Collison, pushed him back with his head, and shot the ball over the top of him.
Memphis by one. Durant in the post and a foul. It's on Tony Allen, his fourth.
Randolph goes to his strong hand, left hand, now watch, in the chest, knocks Collison back, never breaks strides, gets it up, the soft touch, and gets the roll for two.
1 point game, 8:20 to go in the fourth. Keyshawn Prince on the floor. Four fouls, he'll guard Prince. Here's Jackson. Jackson, what a sweet move. In reverse. Thunder by one.
Can't complain a whole lot about the youngster. 5 of 7 from the floor. He's got 7 assists, 13 points in that starting role.
Jewel Link, veteran with his 7th NBA team. Prince to Randolph, backing down on Collison. And Collison commits the foul with 5 seconds remaining on the shot clock, 7:48 remaining in game 4. Randolph to the line.
There's no question that Memphis is going to continue to pound Oklahoma City on the inside. They will get Randolph in the low post area. They bring Gasol back in again. So now, depending on who Oklahoma City would like to play against them, you've got Durant, remember, at the 4 spot, Collison at the 5 spot. One of them has to match up against the 2 big guys from Memphis. That's who they'll post up on the inside, whoever Durant is guarding.
Randolph with 18, has the last 6 for the Grizzlies. 36 points in the paint for Memphis, plus 12 in that category. Air ball for Durant, a rarity. Grizzlies by 1. Undefeated at home during the postseason. They are 18-1 since February 8th. They lost by 4 to the Clippers in the second week of April. Here's Conley. It's a 3. Shot doesn't go. And Martin on the weak side.
Sure enough, they went right at Durant down the low post that time. Martin taking a tough shot. What they did that time, they made a decision to go double team immediately and force Memphis to make perimeter shots rather than beat him up on the inside.
Martin, a victory in game 1, 2 points for the Thunder, the last 2, 6 points each for Memphis, but it has been close in the fourth quarters. And this one has all the makings of what occurred in game 1, 2, and 3. 2.7 remaining on the shot clock, with 6:40 remaining in the fourth, and Memphis by 1.
Not an easy place to take it out.
Prince, Conley, here's Durant. Conley from behind with the steal. And then Conley, a collision with Martin.
You see him running him down from behind. He gets control, and there's the collision right there. The officials call the foul. What a great hustle play from running it down from behind. What looked like was going to be a fast break layup for Oklahoma City. Instead, it winds up being a foul. Possession goes back to Memphis.
Martin picks up his first. Conley, 20 points tonight. Huge steal. Conley, 3rd in the NBA in steals during the regular season. Randolph has been huge in the fourth, blocked by Collison. Here's Reggie Jackson. Jackson steaming by Conley with a layup, 15 points.
Conley lost his footing. He slipped down there. He was guessing that Jackson was going to come back to his left as he planted to try to pick up the charge. He lost his footing and slipped to the ground.
1-point lead for Oklahoma City. Randolph gives it now to Bayless. Bayless turns the corner in the lane. Prince now filling the lane with a runner.
They come on that offside curl, and he catches Durant trailing him. Never stops, puts it down to his strong left hand. That's twice he scored off of that play tonight.
Punch, counter punch. Durant ends that. Durant, 9 of 17, 24 points. Was 0-3 prior to that for a stretch. Thunder back up by 1. Gasol. Prince looks on the inside. Gasol trying to get deep position, can't. Bayless with an air ball. Here's Durant cruising into the front court. Jackson. Cut off by Prince. Five of the shot clock and a foul.
You saw Durant rip through right away. As soon as he felt Bayless's hands or arms on him, he ripped through to make the contact. The official called both hands on immediately.
Look back at game three down the stretch. It was tied at 81 with 1:58 to go after a Fisher three. Jackson, an offensive foul, a charge, and then Derek Fisher with that three to miss, and then Kevin Durant missing two free throws, a rarity.
That fourth quarter wound up 21-21 in that last game. Right now, it's 11-10 in the fourth quarter in favor of the Thunder.
Foul on Tayshaun Prince. Game one was tied at 86 with 2:27 remaining. Game two tied at 89 with 2:41 left. In game three, as we just mentioned, tied at 81 with a 1:58 remaining. Thunder by one. Durant over Prince. Shot doesn't go. Bayless with a rebound.
You can see them putting Durant in the middle of the floor to avoid double teams. Anybody stepping up, he has a wide open look at where the double team's coming from. They can make the appropriate pass that way.
Gasol looking to hand it off to Conley, and a foul. And a foul on the Memphis Grizzlies, and that will put them in the bonus.
A breakdown of communication there. Gasol is expecting Conley to come around the outside, and he yells, "Hey, Mike, you're supposed to come around the outside." Yeah. Conley went to the inside. And then after he dropped the ball off, you see Gasol with the push to try and get possession back.
Bonus situation, the second on Gasol. Cephalosha will head to the free throw line. Ben Salvatore, James Capers, and Joe Crawford gathered at the foul line. And 4:07 remaining here in game four. Cephalosha at the line. Cephalosha, one of two. The Thunder now 16 of 17 from the free throw line, and they lead by two.
You saw Lionel Hollins talking to Mike Conley. Same thing that Gasol had said, you know, was probably reminding him, this is what we had decided to run coming out of that timeout. Here's how you have to do it if you're going to try it again.
3-point lead, 89-86. 4:05 left in the fourth quarter. Conley using the Gasol screen and a Randolph screen. Now swings it. Gasol, high-low feed to Randolph and a foul. That is tough to handle for Collison. He just picked up his fifth. Randolph just so deep. The team's fourth.
There's contact on every play, trying to establish his position in the low post area. Remember, Collison had already been pinned twice in the game, already under the rim, and Randolph got easy scores as a result of it.
18 points, 9 rebounds for Randolph. Here's Gasol. Kick out. Prince to the wing. Bayless. Conley. And a foul on Collison.
Foul on number four.
His sixth, his second time in this series that he has fouled out.
That's the work away from the basketball. The official, Bennett Salvatore, saying Collison grabbed Randolph by the trunks and pulled him down to the ground. Look, lower left part underneath. Collison grabbing the white trunks right there, shoves him down. That's what the official called that right hand grabbing the trunks as he backed into him.
Collison, 10 points off of the bench, 3 rebounds, 2 blocks. Three-point game. Perkins, Ibaka, Durant, Cephalosha, and Jackson on the floor for Scott Brooks. Randolph at the free throw line. And the first one for Randolph is good. 19 points, matching the 19-point performance by his teammate, Marc Gasol.
Amazing, isn't it, that both teams at this moment, 18 free throw attempts. This will be number 19 for Memphis.
20-point game four for Zach Randolph. Five of the clock. Cephalosha to Ibaka, blocked by Gasol, the defensive player of the year.
Tony Allen would not let Kevin Durant touch that basketball. Denied him, made them go in a different direction that time.
Fourth block by Marc Gasol. Randolph to Allen underneath. Looking for Gasol, stolen by Durant. To Cephalosha along the end line. Gasol off of the miss with a rebound. Conley up fake, drives. Conley foul. It's a 1-point game. You may recall in 2011, game four, Memphis and Oklahoma City. The Memphis Grizzlies led that series 2-1 in the Western Conference semifinals. They blew a 22-point lead and eventually lost in triple overtime. The series tied at 2. They eventually lost the series in 7 games, the only time that the Thunder have played a full 7-game series during their Oklahoma City era. As Conley is at the free throw line and ties it. Tonight, the Thunder have led by as many as 17, and it's now the Grizzlies with a 1-point lead.
Come down to execution here. Your defense will stand up, and you take the star player out of the game at Durant, and that's the job of Tony Allen to try and stop him from touching the ball. If he doesn't touch it, he can't shoot it.
Durant, shot, doesn't go, and a foul on the floor.
Ibaka may have turned his ankle that time as he came down. You see him grab it right there in the middle of that crowd. He could have landed on another foot of one of the other players.
Yep, stepped on the left foot of Tayshaun Prince. And Ibaka hopping up and down, trying to walk it off with 2:27 remaining. Durant started the second half, hitting 3 straight shots. Since that time, Durant 1 of 7 in 2 points. Ibaka, 6 of 12, 15 points, 13 rebounds.
Coming into tonight, just 4 of 6 from the free throw line, but thus far tonight for Ibaka, 3 for 3 from the foul line.
And Ibaka and Martin have provided the offense that the Thunder have needed. And have combined to shoot 12 of 24 from the field and 8 of 8 from the free throw line. And Ibaka has responded after struggling in the first 3 games of this series. 17 points now, and the Thunder by 1. 2:20 remaining in game 4. And a 10 of the shot clock. Bayless, no space to operate. Here's Conley on the drive with the offhand.
Remember, early in the game, we talked about Connolly in the last 3 or 4 minutes of the game always seems to come up with huge plays for this Memphis team. There's an example right there.
So slick. 24 points. Prince, a foul. Durant, who missed four free throws in game three and two late. Durant misses a second there, has 25 points. Gasol. Prince saves it. Tied at 92. Randolph. Perkins on him. Gives it to Bayless. Seven on the shot clock. Bayless drives into traffic. Tapped out and a fresh shot clock.
Two straight second chance opportunities for Memphis. Eventually, you've got to get a defensive rebound. Keep giving them a chance to score. They're going to do it.
Under a minute remaining. Randolph is fouled. Game one was a one-possession game with under a minute remaining. Game two, a two-possession game with under a minute. And game three, a one-possession game with under a minute remaining. And here we are again.
You see Perkins crowding Randolph on the outside 20 feet from the basket rather than give you defensive fakes at him. Understand he really doesn't want to shoot that 20 to 22 foot shot. He'd rather initiate the contact, stay away from bumping him as he puts it on the floor to give him two easy free throws.
Perkins is fifth. Memphis by one. Derek Fisher in. Tony Allen in. Prince, Gasol, Allen, Conley, and Randolph at the free throw line. For Memphis. For the Thunder, Perkins, Ibaka, Durant, Jackson, and Fisher. Randolph misses the second. Durant with a rebound.
Jersey surrounding Durant.
Memphis trail by 17 in the second quarter. Gasol. Here's Conley. Too strong. Hustling, gets his own rebound. Pulls it back out.
You gotta foul him. You gotta foul him now. Don't let more time run off the clock.
And finally, and you see Scott Brooks' reaction as he was screaming at his team to foul.
Now think about it. Three second chance opportunities all happening in the last minute and a half of the game. There's the three white jerseys all surrounding Durant. Randolph sticks the hand in and strips them to give Memphis the possession.
Scott Brooks incensed, and it's been Gasol misses the first. And you think about the execution of the Thunder down the stretch in game two as well as game three, and right there here in game four.
Oklahoma City will squeeze Zach Randolph with two people. Durant on the top side, Perkins on the bottom side, so he doesn't get an offensive rebound.
2-point lead. Timeout taken by the Thunder. Randolph missed a key free throw. Gasol missed a key free throw. But the Grizzlies lead by two with 10.9 seconds remaining for Scott Brooks in the Thunder.
Well, Scott Brooks has to decide right now. Are you going for the two? But if the three-point line opens up, do you take the shot and try to win it right there? And what Lionel Hollins is preaching is the fact that, look, a two ties us, but a three beats us. So you people on the perimeter with the perimeter shooters, the three-point shooters, you got to stay close enough, be at home to take them off the line, run them off the line. The obvious would be that they're going to try and get the ball to Durant, so that they go and double Durant and take it out of his hands. You start doubling and scrambling, that leaves people wide open on the perimeter. That's the problem.
10.9 seconds remaining in game four. Memphis by two.
Try and get the ball in Durant's hands as quickly as possible to give him the time to operate.
Fisher to Durant up top. Durant driving. Durant ties it. Scoop shot by Durant. Tied at 94. 6.4 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter.
94 all. Here's what they ran. They run the cutter just to free him up on the outside. Once they get him out of there, you're going to have a double screen for him with two Oklahoma City guys to get Durant to the top of the circle and give him that one-on-one opportunity. Once they run the cutter off, here's the two screens. Durant gets it in his hand, and then he's coming back to his strong side. Shooter in the corner, ready to catch and shoot. Instead, Durant with the finish to tie the game.
Tied at 94. 6.4 seconds remaining in the fourth. Where do the Grizzlies go?
Guy who's made big plays for them over and over again at the end of the game is Mike Conley. Reggie Jackson's had a tough time keeping Conley in front of him. Remember, you've always got the post presence of Zach Randolph down low. Don't be surprised to see Conley with the ball at the top of the circle after they run Bayless off that double screen.
Prince to inbound it up top. Conley, 5 seconds, gives it to Zach Randolph. Randolph, 2 seconds. Randolph fading, blocked by Perkins. Overtime in game four. Tied at 94, game four, 2 years later. Getting set for overtime.
There's one thing to keep in mind. Perkins, who just made that big block, has 5 personal fouls. Next one, he's gone. Collison is already out of the game. That means they probably will go with Khabib in the overtime.
Here's Durant. Gasol with a rebound. And talking about that game with Lionel Hollins, he said, look, we're more mature, we're more poised. He said, Mike Conley's better, Marc Gasol's better. We're a better team today than we were 2 years ago, game four in that triple overtime loss, 133-123. Tony Allen up fake, driving, and it rolls in, 96-94.
Reggie Jackson pounding himself on the head, realizing what a terrible mistake to just go for the ball, they leave his feet, and give him a wide open lane to the basket. That's not how you close out as a defender.
Jackson. Here's Ibaka trying to go to work on Randolph. Tough angle. Perkins, offensive rebound, kick out to Fisher. And there are 4 minutes remaining here in overtime in game four. Oklahoma City led by 17. 46-29 back in the second quarter. And James Capers, and a foul. That's Allen's fifth,
which would be critical for Oklahoma City if they could foul Allen out. And he's called for reaching in on the arm. Right there is where he grabs the wrist. That's the official call.
Shot clock at 4. Ibaka makes a move. Clock at 1. Fisher. And Prince comes away with it. Gasol, 5 on the shot clock, 4 on the clock, over Perkins. Zach Randolph, offensive rebound, put back. Largest lead of the night for the Grizzlies.
See him pin Ibaka under the rim. The ball's on the floor. Ibaka had no chance of going down for it because of the way Randolph had him pinned under there.
Randolph and Gasol combined 43 points, 22 rebounds. Shot clock at 4. Durant fading. Out of bounds.
Watch under the basket as the shot goes up. Randolph pins him with that big body. Reaches down on the floor, picks it up, and lays it in.
Pivotal game four here in Memphis. Grizzlies lead the series 2-1. Backing down, Randolph, shot no. Gasol, and a foul against Memphis, against Marc Gasol. His third.
Very physical up front right now, realizing that Oklahoma City very thin. Look at Gasol in the pack, spreading his arms out, trying to get the blue jerseys out of there so he can come up with that rebound.
Double comes to Durant. Jackson, Fisher. It's a three. Fisher has made so many big threes throughout his playoff career.
That's what happens when you double team, which they did to Durant, and then Oklahoma City swings it quickly. Tough time getting back in the rotations and getting to Fisher.
In his first field goal of the night, it's a one-point deficit for the Thunder. Gasol backing down on Durant. Double comes, kick out. Here's Conley. And a huge rebound, Ibaka. Jackson. Offensive foul. And a charge on Reggie Jackson. That's his fifth.
He might have cramped up right there. That's what it looks like, as if he cramped up all of a sudden.
He said he's fine as he looks over, trying to run it off.
Gasol gets over there, plants himself, and it's one of the things that the youngster will have to learn is when it's time to pull up for that in-between little floater. We've seen so many of the young players develop that floating shot coming down the lane for about 8 feet out, which avoids the offensive foul.
Another critical offensive foul charge in game three, and another one here in game four. 1 point lead for Memphis. Conley, Prince, up fake, gets by Martin. Knocked around. And a foul is going to be charged to Tayshaun Prince.
It was a good call going after the ball. You saw the collision take place underneath. Memphis would have had that rebound other than the collision, which was the foul. Now everybody's going after it. There you see Prince come in and crashes into Durant.
And the fourth on Prince. Timeout, brother. Timeout on the floor. Memphis by one, game four in overtime. 56.6 seconds remaining. Memphis. One full, both teams with 220s left. Thunder with a foul to give.
Letting Durant bring it down the floor so that they cannot deny him the basketball.
Durant pulls up, shot too strong.
He's upset that he actually slid a little bit. His feet went out from under him, so he didn't have the balance that he wanted to.
Gasol, now a handoff to Conley. 7 on the shot clock. 5 on the shot clock. Conley to Gasol. 2 on the clock. Gasol makes it. And a hand in the face. Timeout Thunder. 22.8 seconds remaining in overtime. The Grizzlies lead by 3.
Clock running down. Taken out of their offensive set. The defenders stay a little bit too long with that half double team. They find Gasol, and it doesn't take him long to get out of his hands. Watch his feet slip right there. He slides with that left foot, not the balance that he wanted. You can see the ball shot a little bit too long as he tried to address, and then there it is, holding the double team a little bit too long. Gasol's open. He knows he's got to get up there on the rim. Hits nothing but the bottom of the net.
What a tremendous scene here in Memphis. Fans on their feet throughout the late stages of the fourth and here in overtime. The two bigs for Memphis, Gasol and Randolph, have absolutely been dominant tonight.
Well, hasn't that been the case in the series thus far? They've just been too much for Oklahoma City to handle. They pound it inside, they make you come back, and the perimeter guys have done just enough damage by making big shots from the outside. With 22 plus seconds remaining now, you can't start fouling intentionally too early, or it makes it a long game.
Inbounds pass stolen away. Fisher was looking for Martin. And a costly turnover. Fisher playing in his 239th career playoff game, second all time behind Robert Ory.
Well, you see Fisher bouncing it, and the only guy that knew it was going there was Tony Allen.
Timeout taken by Memphis. 22nd timeout. Seconds remaining, and Mike, what a sensational comeback by the Memphis Grizzlies thus far, down 17, and of course forcing overtime, and then Perkins late in the fourth quarter, and then here, of course, in overtime.
One of the things that jumps out at me is all those second shots that Memphis got on those possessions where it could have been Oklahoma City's ball to come down and try to get a score. They never got a chance because Memphis stayed after, knocked it back out. It was three more field goal attempts than they should have had. And now what they have to do is hope for the steal. They're down three. You're going to have to foul immediately. They're in the bonus, so Memphis will go to the free throw line. All they have to do is step up and make their foul shots.
21.1 seconds remaining in overtime. Memphis by three. They advance the ball. Prince with Cephalosha guarding the inbounds. And a foul. It's on Ibaka. And that is his third.
Thunder's 15th foul.
And the 15th foul.
Scotty Brooks probably felt they were very close to getting a 5-second count right there and a turnover and their possession back again, but the official feeling Ibaka had too much jersey, held him, restricted his movement.
Bayless in, Randolph out, Gasol at the free throw line. Gasol, 7 of 8 from the free throw line and a 4-point lead. 23 points for Randolph, 23 for Mark Gasol. And then a smile with a 4-point lead. Second doesn't go. Durant weaving his way into the front court, and the three doesn't register. Jackson chasing it and hustling for it, ends up in the second row. And Jackson will take the long way back around. And great hustle that time by Reggie Jackson.
You see Durant sizing it up in transition, hoping he can make the three and maybe get fouled on it. Trying to decide who the officials are awarding the ball to. They see Bayless's hand touch it.
Jackson was already out of bounds when he touched it. There's no call yet, and Joe Crawford, Bennett Salvatore, this veteran crew, as James Capers heads over. Take a look.
This is such a veteran crew, Matt, that this overtime is past their bedtime, all of them.
I don't say that. Ruling on the floor, it is off of Bayless.
Well, we couldn't tell there. Was no. Jackson out of bounds already?
Lucas's left foot may have been out of bounds already.
But if it hits him while he's out of bounds, he's part of out of bounds.
You see him, he's out of bounds right there.
Bayless there. Jackson there.
The official still studying the video. One 97, 12.6 seconds remaining here in overtime, game four, and a 4-point lead for Memphis.
Two things I have to straighten out, Mac. Whose ball is it? How much time is on the clock?
It's going to be Memphis basketball, and they're going to put time back on the clock, 13 seconds, as you mentioned. Jackson out of bounds, touching the basketball. 4-point game. 13 seconds left.
Make it hard for them to catch it, trying to come up with the steal. If no steal, you've got to foul.
And a timeout taken by Prince in Memphis. Grizzlies lead 2-1.
20-second timeout.
Overtime action from the Mid-South. And the Grizzlies lead by 4. They have possession of the basketball. 13 seconds remaining.
City with a 20 left. Remember now, with 13 seconds remaining, it's a two-possession game, but that's still plenty of time left. You foul when you have to here. If you can't get the steal, put them on the line. They miss a free throw. You'll have time to still get two opportunities playing the foul game.
Bayless back to Prince. Prince trying to keep it away from Fisher, and a foul. So Fisher with a foul. 4-point lead for Memphis. 10 seconds remaining. Prince will go to the free throw line. Prince, his first free throw attempt of the night.
And since he's come to Memphis in the trade, shooting just 59% from the free throw line for the remainder of the regular season.
And one hit about every part of the rim. Largest lead of the night for the Grizzlies. Scott Brooks' Thunder led by 17. A tremendous first quarter. And then early on in the second quarter, but then Jared Bayless and the Grizzlies cut into that and made it a single-digit deficit going into halftime. Durant driving, misses. 103-97. The Grizzlies take game four in overtime, and they lead this best-of-seven series 3-1 over the defending Western Conference champion, Oklahoma City Thunder.
Well, like Scott Brooks said, we have not given up at the defensive end of the floor. They found a way this entire game to hang right there, give themselves a chance to win, but you must credit Memphis for coming back at the end, tying it back up again, and then in overtime, just securing the win.
Grizzlies have won 19 of their last 20 games here at home. Let's send it over to Marty Snyder. Marty?
Well, Zach, you're up 3-1. Is there a way to describe how critical this win was?
This was the most critical game of the series. Here at home, we was in this 2 years ago. And we came out, we played tough, you know, they played great. We hung in there. They got on us early, but we kept fighting and fighting. That was the game.
You and I talked yesterday about that 2011 triple overtime game. You said it took you all summer to get over it. When you went to overtime tonight, were you thinking, oh, no, here we go again?
I definitely thought about that. You know, it ran through my mind. But, you know, I told myself and the team, let's go. You know, we can do this. We came back this far. You know, now down that many, and we kept fighting, and it was grit and grind basketball, and we overcame it.
Down 17, Coach told me you simply got outplayed in the first half. How did you guys turn it around?
We just stuck together. We just poured it out. We got stops when we needed to. We got out fast in transition and got the ball up, and guys made shots.
They kind of played their game tonight. They played the pace they wanted. They had kind of everything go their way. Do you feel like, in a way, you may have taken their best shot in this game?
Well, we took a real good shot, so.
First team, baby, first team.
Tony Allen, reminding Tony Allen, all defensive team.
First team, man. That's what we call
it. How about his job on Kevin Durant?
Man, Tony Allen been the grit and grind, the heart of this team the whole season. The guy that came a long way, and he a leader on this team.
Congratulations on the big win.
Thanks.
First team all defense, Tony Allen. Memphis outscored Oklahoma City 9-3 in overtime to take game 4.